Hello friends, the title of the video is Today's Deglobalization. This is not the first time that the world has deglobalized. Between the First World War and Second World War, world trade collapsed. The export to GDP ratio fell from the peak of 16% in 1913 to just over 6% in 1945. In John Keynes' memorable words, this contraction was the result of projects and politics of militarism and imperialism, of racial and cultural rivalries, of monopolies, restrictions, and exclusion. Today's deglobalization was brought on by other factors. The first factor is the protectionist barrier. The trade restrictions imposed by US President since 2017 have been relatively limited overall and targeted mainly China. At the global level, they have been partly offset by the ongoing new free trade agreement, such as Economic Partnership Agreement that the European Union and Japan concluded in 2018. Another more important factor behind today's deglobalization is the breakdown of global value chain. It is itself the result of China's transformation from a small export-driven economy into a much larger economy, more reliant on domestic demand. The third important factor that influenced the process of deglobalization is the recent pandemic, which is already underway. It is too early to be sure, but one possibility stands out. One plausible scenario is a generalized retreat in which deglobalization accelerates as countries and firms reassess the benefits of trade against the risks of import dependence. To conclude, indeed the pendulum may be swinging in the opposite direction towards the resurgence of older development ideas such as Big Push. In the Big Push, developing countries were advised to replace successful export-led growth models with inward-oriented strategies, that is, import substitution. Thank you for watching my video.